Would you believe Anna Quinlan down there has given me loads of tips on the first couple of weeks of parenthood, so I'm going to go back to Galway, a new man. Thanks very much for all the good wishes. I know we're behind time, but with this lineup of guests that we have, so what? That's what I was saying. Ladies and gentlemen, our next guest is a man who has been there and done that in the management arena. He holds a legacy that is described as immense. Has won provincial titles not only in Connacht but also in Munster. He had a Mayo team down the home straight in two All-Ireland finals only to be picked at the post on both occasions. This year he left the glitz and glamour of inter-county senior football to help out the Achill on what was a roller coaster of a year we went on. Please welcome to the stage Mr. John Maughan. John, how are you? Welcome back to Achill.
Thank you.
John, let's start with your playing days and your early playing days from Mayo through the early 80s. And some cards would start from a glamorous affair.
Well, not quite. I was lucky enough to play minor football player for 2 years. Having gone to Carmel College Moat, where I won a Hogan Cup medal. Came in and won 2 series of medals at UCG as it was then. And I just won an All-Ireland 21 medal with Mayo back in 1983. And progressed on to the Premier Senior team when I was 22 years of age. And at 24, a year older than Jason is now, my career was over. Unfortunately, I got a bad knee injury. What came from us, I thought, a routine cartilage operation. And 5 operations later, I didn't play again for about 9 years. But we had some good times. The Mayo football team back in the early to mid-80s probably underachieved. I felt that there was a team there, certainly that after the Mayo won that 21 title in 83, with obviously the great players like TJ McGowan and Willie Joe Pat and these guys were in their prime. And unfortunately, I think we probably underperformed. We were beating the Irish in the final 1985 week there at Dublin. But that team was certainly good enough to make progress.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you just stick with us for the next 20 minutes and maybe just a bit of hush so we can get through the next good interview. So we have great guests to talk to. John, did you always feel that you were going to go into management?
Not at all. I arrived there by default, obviously. I was in the army, and when I got injured that time at 26 years of age, I took over the management of the Defence Force football team for 2 years. And I was living in Galway City at the time, commuting to Custer Bars at the moment. I came home, this was pre mobile phone time, and I came home and my wife told me that some crowd from Clare wanted to meet me. And so I went down to meet them, of course, and they asked me would I train the Clare football team, and I told them I would, on one condition, that I was a manager as well. So I was a cocky enough young fella.
Let's just put that into perspective. We have a 28-year-old John Maughan that's 4 years older than I am today.
Yeah. That's
good. Asked to manage Clare.
Yeah, Clare were pretty desperate, by God, obviously.
But let's put this in perspective. Over the last 93 years, 91 of the Munster finals have been won by Cork and Kerry.
Yeah.
You had, if you're a numbers man, you had 1% chance of success. Did you really believe that you could do anything with Clare?
No, not for that. That's my answer. I have to be honest here. I was taking over a team that was rooted in Division 4. They played an RMB championship, I think, the week prior to me going down to meet them. I could only get 13 players on the pitch. They didn't have to get the bus driver to play with them, but it was that bad. So the first year, we trained exceptionally hard. That was in 1990. We trained really, really hard, and I could see when we played Kerry the Munster Championship on that first occasion with that town, it was fitness that beat us. We just weren't strong enough. And I reckon if we worked a little bit harder the following year, there might be an opportunity. So it was in 1991, we won that All-Ireland B final, which was a great stepping stone. And we just got the confidence going on the players. And I was around actually hand-picking oppositions that I knew we could beat just to get a bit of confidence into the team. And there's some very, very good players that came out of it. We're really, really good.
So in 1992, you pulled off one of the most historic achievements in GAA.
It was a special day for Clare people. Obviously, those of you that might have watched it remember that was Martin Morrissey was a young reporter at the time, and he came out with the line, he is a clear man, of course, and you know that famous line, don't be calm, Minton, be clear for next week. And I don't think it was, but yeah, it was fantastic. To beat what I would term the real aristocrats of football, Kerry, to beat them down in Limerick on that occasion was something special. Jack O'Shea was, I think that was his last game playing for Kerry. A young Seamus Moynihan made his debut that day at midfield for Kerry. Poor old Mickey Ned Sullivan was a manager. He got was referred to as the brown brat by Gary the Iran or whatever it was. Unfortunately, he got the sack after that game. But yeah, it was very special. And we went on to an Ireland semi final. We were extremely unlucky against Dublin in an Ireland semi final. So Clare could have actually got into an Ireland final in 92, which would be quite magical. But it was a lovely time.
So let's fast forward to 96. You took over Mayo, Division 3 team at the time. You know, things were going very poorly in the county from a football perspective, and you took over. You won the Connacht.
Yeah, I was based with the United Nations on Cyprus, and I remember listening to the Connacht final, Mayo versus Galway in June, and I was close to tears. The Mayo were so pathetic and so poor on that particular occasion. And they just had been relegated. I think were bad, was on issues at the management, I think, and I think Kevin McStay was brought in midterm to assist the then manager, Anthony Egan, if I recall. But I came home to do an interview. They rang me up to see if I came home from Cyprus to do an interview. So I was commuting, I wasn't with the point, I was commuting from Cyprus for the first three or four National League games. I wasn't being paid by the mine, incidentally, but things were pretty low in 1995-96 for Mayo.
And you came so close. It was literally the bounce of the ball on both occasions, the drawn game, obviously, and then the replay that really stripped Sam Maguire from the grasp of Mayo, from the grasp of John Maughan.
Yeah, some of the newer boys might recall 1996, but it was certainly one that got away. I mean, we should have won that in the final. Certainly, I'm partly to blame for it. We were 6 points up, like it was 12 or 14 minutes ago, and she wasn't good. It was very, very disappointing.
Does it sit bad with you then?
It does, yeah.
You didn't deliver a big prize.
I need a bowl as well for a couple of months. It's like you're
I knew you were that.
Yeah, I'm pretty disappointed. But we got back in 97 again, and we were caught by Kerry in 1997. We weren't as fresh, and Kerry had been hurting for the previous year. Paulie O'Shea was in charge, and they had revved up, and unfortunately we lost that one. But I think we were beat by a better team in 1997.
Then after 2004, Kerry, you got to the other, you were back in charge of Mayo. Kerry were back in the All-Ireland final versus Mayo. Really, you know, there's no complaints there. They were just a far superior team. They were probably one of the teams of this era.
They were, yeah. I mean, Kerry were awesome. Like, I mean, I think we were beaten by a better team. But just to add to the misery, I was also managing the Mayo 21 team, and we lost the All-Ireland final a week after the 2004 senior final. And I just a couple of months previously, I was managing across the line on my home team, and we lost that All-Ireland final as well. So in the space of about 6 months, I lost the three All-Ireland finals.
Oh,
poor John. Let's talk about positive, and let's talk about Achill, John. You arrived down on the 7th of February, I have to say, for probably the first six trips you were down, it absolutely last ring, blowing a hurricane. We finally got into summer, and the midget set your life for about 6 weeks in a row.
Yeah, I recall the midgets more than the rain. But it was Paul. I know Paul for a long number of years, obviously, you know, at the bar, and I actually did a coach for a trainer a couple of years ago when he was a young fella, but playing on the 21s. But I knew Paul, and typically he came in and asked me to go down and do a session or two. And obviously, when I came down, I have to say it was marvelous. I never had anything but good memories. Driving up and down Casabara was easy because I enjoyed getting to know the lads, and I couldn't stop, quite honestly, to, every Friday night I was looking forward to getting down and just watching the team grow and get better as the weeks went by. And as Paul mentioned earlier, looking at some of the young fellas in particular, he mentioned four, but there are other lads there, 15 and 16 years of age, just popping up, and I think there's a great future for Athlone GA Club. And when you see 30 guys, you know, going to June and doing so well, But, it's, yeah, I must admit, I found it very, very easy, and I really, really enjoyed it.
I have to say, working with John, as we came towards the end of the year, it seemed to be that you got a great kick out of watching the progression of the individual and the team as they bonded together, and didn't put a huge amount of weight on what we won and what we didn't win, but the fact that we progressed and improved so well from 7th of February right up until the 27th of November.
Yeah, as any of the guests here will know, Gary or Alan or Jason will know, like, I mean, winning is nice, no question about that, but it's, sport is bigger than that. Like, I mean, Paul mentioned the memories and the good days, and we had some great days, and obviously Paul has mentioned the Connacht semi-final in particular. I thought we were gone, and to see the remarkable courage and the resilience of the team at that occasion was just a joy to behold. It was absolutely fantastic, and as I say, that was one of the great, great days. And but I witnessed this about 2 or 3 years. I do a fair bit of cycling, but I was out cycling for a very good breast cancer cycle thing called the Pink Ribbon every year at Castlebar, organised by a number of girls in there. And we've been doing a route for the last 4 or 5 years, and we changed about 2 years ago when we took in an Achill. And I have to say, I never will forget, but I want to acknowledge the fact that the welcome we got and the way the people of Achill came out and supported the cyclists out of every house. I certainly will never forget that. I want to be able the opportunity to acknowledge them. Thank you. It's a privilege to be asked here tonight. It's a privilege to be asked to get involved and to be considered good enough to be asked down and coach a team or give a help out. I'm very, very lucky. Sport has been very, very good to me. I've been lucky enough to travel with teams all over the world. And I was in Hong Kong with the All Stars. I was in America, Australia. It's been really, really good. And it's lovely to see so many young fellas playing the sport, hopefully winning a few titles along the way. But I mean, it is all about the friendships and the fun times you have it, and you never regret it once you play it, and at least you go out there and be the best it can be, as I say.
So, what's next for John Maughan? I know Paul and the management team have the first training session penciled in on the 9th of February, and you've even a new rain jacket bought for you.
Yeah, the next challenge for me is to try and win a county title at Achill in 2015.